Good day. Welcome to CodeRage 12. My name is Bob Swart. This is a session about customizing DataSnap method output, or more specifically, how we can return a query in truly consumable JSON format. But first, a little bit about myself. I am Bob Swart. I'm also known as Dr. Bob, and I'm forever loyal to Delphi. I'm an Embarcadero MVP, a Delphi software developer, author of almost 1,000 articles on Delphi in the past 2 decades, a Delphi consultant, trainer, coach and reseller of Delphi and TMS software. I live in Helmond Brandenvoort, that's in the Netherlands. I have spoken at Borland conferences since 1993, and together with Kerry Jensen, I'm currently speaking at the Delphi Developer Days 2017 special 2-day database workshop, all about DataSnap with FireDeck as well as RAD Server. So for more information about DataSnap, check out our next city, which is Frankfurt on November 27th and 28th, which is the last city of our tour this year. If you want to contact me to get more information about DataSnap or other Delphi topics, or some consultancy or any other method related to Delphi, you can always email me at bob@ebob42.com. The agenda. These are the topics for this session. DataSnap server methods return output in a way that DataSnap clients expect. A dataset returns JSON in a specific format that we can understand, and so does a TFD JSON dataset type, something that really Delphi clients can understand without problems. This is ideal for DataSnap clients, but sometimes less ideal for developers using other tools or other development environments to consume this JSON output. They may not know what to do with the T dataset JSON or the TFT JSON datasets JSON. And maybe we want to return output in a different format, not JSON but XML for example. Well, in this session I will demonstrate how we can use the TDS invocation metadata class to fully customize the output of DataSnap server methods, returning the JSON we want and other people need, or even XML or any output format we need or desire. So, let's create a DataSnap server application to show the JSON that we can produce. File, new, other, and then from the DataSnap server category, I'm picking a DataSnap web broker application. I don't need the explicit DataSnap REST application that will generate JavaScript to test the stuff because that's unsafe to publish anyway, to deploy, so I take a DataSnap web broker application. No Linux at this time. I want just a standalone GUI application. Let's stick at VCL. Port 8080 will be fine on the next page. I do want to have a server method class, but no sample methods. No filters. They are not used for REST servers anyway. I don't want to use the mobile connectors. Don't need for an additional server module. And for this demo session, I don't need authentication or authorization, so just a server method class. Descending from the tdata module, so we can place data access components to get access to a database where I want to perform a query on. Click on finish. Now we should get a new DataSnap server project that we can save, for example. So save this project, form unit 1, that's fine, web module unit 1, that's great, server method unit 1, and the project itself will be my DataSnap server. If we switch to the web module unit, we get the DS HTTP web dispatcher component. Sometimes I have customers who don't like the fact that in the URL to call DataSnap server methods, we need to specify the words DataSnap and REST. Well, as a bonus tip, we can eliminate the DataSnap and the REST by removing clearing three properties. First of all, DS context is set to DataSnap slash. If you just clear that property, Delphi will enter the slash. And you have also to clear the path info, which is DataSnap star. You have to clear that as well, so this slash corresponds to this star. And finally, there's the REST context, which is set to REST. If we clear that one as well, and now we have just a DataSnap server without the need for the DataSnap and the REST. So we can just call localhost 8080 then the name of my server method class, followed by the name of the method that they want to execute, followed by any parameters, which can be quite handy. Let's get to the server method unit for our actual work for producing the DataSnap server methods. On the server methods unit, I want to make a connection to my database. In this case, since everyone with Delphi also has Interbase, I will use an Interbase employees database. So I want to use an FD connection, I'm using FireDeck. Right click, go to the connection editor, and I want to use a named connection. I want to use the named connection for employee the database, the employee database of Interbase, stored in users public documents embarcadero studio 19 samples data in that directory. SysDBA master key, so if we test the connection, then yes, we can make a connection to my Interbase database. Okay, of course I need to set the login prompt to false so we don't get that login prompt dialog. Now I want to use an FD query, a query to execute on my database. For example, I want to find employees that are from a specific country or have a job in a specific country. So inside my query editor, I can specify select star from employee. Now just execute to see all available fields. So that's emp no, first name, last name, etc. Note the hire date, which is your date, and job country. Now there are a number of job countries: USA, England, Canada, Japan, Italy, France, Switzerland. So just as an example, I want to extend this query by searching for employees only from a specific country. So where job country equals country, a named parameter. So with this query I can select one or more employees that are from a specific country, and I want to return the results of this query as a JSON packet, so someone else can consume that JSON and, for example, put it on a website to show it visually, while the DataSnap server only produces the JSON to work with. So let's see if we can still execute the method. Yes, as a parameter we can, for example, specify USA as an example value, and here you see that we can get the result of only USA employees. Okay, let's check the parameter here. We should have one parameter of type country, which is a white string, so that's okay. Let's now switch to the code editor and write my server method to return the output of this function. So that's a function function employees with country as my parameter value, returning a dataset. Ctrl Shift C to generate the skeleton. In Delphi we could return a T dataset as a result of a DataSnap server method, which is quite handy because both the server and the client can understand what a dataset consists of and how to retrieve the data from it. For our example, ftquery1.close, let's close the query first, then assign the parameter, that's param by name, of my country, and let's assign the value of that one to country, and let's not use value, but let's just use the value. Assign it to country, then we can open up the query again, and finally, as a result, we can return my FD query 1. And Delphi will marshal the FD query 1, the entire FD query 1, to a JSON packet and send it to, well, to the clients connecting to it. We can compile and run this application, run the DataSnap web broker server, click on start to start the server, click an open browser, so it will start the default browser with my DataSnap server being called. So that's localhost 8080, we get the result DataSnap server. Now normally you would have to specify slash DataSnap slash REST here, but since I eliminated them for my web module, we only have to specify the T server methods 1 and then the name of my function, which is employees, press enter, and here we get the employees. Since I didn't specify a country, it's an empty country and no employees, it doesn't work for no country, so I need to specify, for example, USA here as input parameter for country, and then we get the query for all employees that work in have a job country specified equal to USA. Now this is the JSON that my query returns, that is returned with the T dataset. And it may be perfectly understandable by Delphi itself, but for other people who work with JSON, it's not really pretty JSON. As you can see, the result is a table. We can open up the table to get some more information, and now we get the first field empno and all possible values from empno, followed by all possible values of first name, all possible values of last name. So all fields and values are included, but they're not in a record by record way. It's more like a column by column way. And if you open up the table node, you see there's some metadata information about empno. And I have to admit, I'm a Delphi developer, but I don't know what these numbers and true and false and false and false means. So I really doubt that a PHP or JavaScript developer knows how to interpret this. They can, of course, extract all the values from all the developers from the JSON, but they have to do it column by column based, and then somehow put it into a JSON structure that they can use and put on a website. So this may be ideal for Delphi developers, because in a client we can just extract this and put this in a dataset. Delphi will do that for us automatically. But for any other development environment having to consume this JSON, this is well, really less ideal. So what can we do about this? Well, the T dataset returns a dataset in read-only value, so it's probably useful for Delphi clients if you want to have it as a read-only value, but other developers cannot use JSON very much. So we can also return something else when it comes to passing datasets from a data snap server to a client. That's a tftjson datasets. That's a structure that contains potentially more than one dataset. So let's see how the JSON from that looks like. We have to add the data.firedeck.json reflect unit to the users clause, and instead of returning a T dataset, we can return a tftjson datasets. So we have to change the implementation a little bit. So instead of returning a query, we have to create a tftjson datasets. JSON datasets dot create. And now we can use a tftjson datasets writer to add to the result my fd query 1. So tftjson datasets writer, that should be add to my result. Oh, list add, sorry. List add. The dataset writer has a class function list add, so we should add to the results my FD query 1. We can actually add more than one query to an FDJSON dataset, more than one table query or FDMem table or any dataset to an FDJSON datasets. And as the name kindly indicates, this could be a JSON dataset, so that could be potentially more useful to export to the outside world. From a Delphi client, we can actually accept the tftjson datasets and use it to fill in one or more FDMem tables and make any change to it, send updates back to the server, which is really very powerful in combination, the combination of FireDeck with DataSnap in that respect. But let's see what the JSON looks like that we return from this function. So let's run my DataSnap server again, click on start, open the browser, and then re-execute my tServerMethods1 class, calling employees from the USA again. That's calling employees from the USA again. Employees. Now we get an error message: unknown storage format bin. To register it, we can drop a component TFD stand storage bin link to my project. Well, that's a bit strange, because this component is called the TFD JSON datasets. So why would it need a binary storage format? Well, let's just add the binary storage format. So go to design mode, and we can search for the TFD storage components, the FD storage bin link for binary formats, XML link for XML formats, or JSON link for JSON output formats. Apparently we need to drop the storage bin link on the form. And if you add that to the form and click on save, let's see the users clause. Currently ends with data Firedeck JSON reflect. If I save my unit, the Firedeck stand storage bin unit is added to the users clause. And that's actually the only use for this component. We can now remove the component again, because we only needed to add that unit to the users clause to register that storage format. So with that storage format added, we can close my DataSnap server again, rerun it, and try to find out why we needed the binary storage format in the first place. So let's refresh the output, and here we get the result of the TFD JSON datasets. So this is a JSON class, it's a type ID, it has fields, and embedded is a JSON object, JSON pairs, all kinds of stuff, TFD query. And here's finally my actual query, but it looks like the data is truly in binary format. So although my query has been executed and we get a really complex JSON structure with my FD query 1, the actual data is passed in binary format. So this TFD JSON datasets, it may be a JSON construct as container, but the actual data is in binary format. And this is binary format that Delphi understands, but of course no external party trying to consume my JSON will be able to understand the JSON from this FD dataset. So we have to look for another solution. Instead of returning a Delphi T dataset or TFT JSON datasets, we should return something that is known to the other side. Simple basic types, strings, integers, floats, dates, structures and arrays of these elements. So I can understand that a PHP developer doesn't know about a Delphi dataset, but it should know about arrays and structures of these strings and integers, etc. So for that purpose, I created a simple class, let's add the units, employees, that corresponds to the records inside my employee table. So it's a TEmployee class with private fields, fmp, no first name, last name, phone extension, etc. Then a public procedure read, to read the fields from a dataset and assigning all the data to my private fields. And then public properties for each of these fields from the dataset. Note by the way that property full name is a read-only property, because that's a calculated field in my dataset. So this is a single employee. I also defined a TEmployees class for multiple employees, which is just an array of TEmployee. Delphi dataset server methods can export classes as well. They cannot export arrays, but they can export classes. So if I have to export an array of employee, I have to embed it inside a class, TEmployees. I can export that class, and the field is employees, and that can be a dynamic length of employees. Since the classes are embedded in the TEmployees, I have to add a destructor to get rid of and cleanly get rid of my employees. And I need a procedure read to read it from the dataset as well. Implementation, assuming we have a dataset which contains all these fields, so I'm assuming a lot here, and it's positioned at the current record, we can read that record and assign all the values to my fields. The read for the employees assumes that the query has been opened. We can go to the first records and then walk through all the queries and just create a new employee in the list and read the current record and assign it to the employees. In order to create the list, we have to call setLengthOnEmployees for the record count of my query. So if we have one employee from Italy or three from France, the length of my return employees field will be 1 or 3 or 42 or whatever we need, and then we just loop through it and fill in all my employees. In the destructor, we need to call free on all the embedded employees and then assign nil to the dynamic array so everything is freed again. So with this particular employee class inside, we can change my server method implementation again. First, we need to add the unit to the users clause. So let's add it here, employees. And now, instead of returning a tftjson datasets, we should return a tEmployees class. Now, this class can be marshaled to JSON by Delphi itself, so we can just return the tEmployees class. So after we've created, we opened the query, result is tEmployees.create, and we only need to call result.read passing fdquery1 as parameter, so it will read from my open query all the possible employees, add them to the result, to the employees dataset, which will return them into JSON and send them to the output stream. So with this class, with the fields that start with the F and the properties that have no F but start with uppercase letter, by the way, JSON usually starts with lowercase, camel case. With these five lines, we should be able to export truly JSON that hopefully some other languages and development environments can also understand. So let's run this example. Click on start and open the browser again. Well, we can close this one and just, this is the previous example with the tftjson datasets. If I refresh it, now we get some more readable JSON, and this truly is result type employees tEmployees with ID and fields, and here are my individual employees. This is the employee with an ID and fields, and here are all the fields from employee. However, there are a little bit of problems here. First of all my fields have the F prefix. The F prefix is not removed for some reason, and I would like it to be exported without the F prefix. Also, look at the higher date fields, which is a floating point number. Now, internally, Delphi's T-date times are floating point numbers, but I would like to export the actual date here, the actual date as a string or as a date field, because a PHP developer or a JavaScript developer, they may not know what this floating point number stands for. So it's nice, close, but we are not really there yet. This is far more readable, and I'm really sure that any JavaScript or a JSON developer can actually extract the data from this structure as compared to the previous examples that I've shown, but we're not quite finished. Let's get a little more control over the JSON that's being output. For that, I'm going to use a tEmployee class and add a method, a function to JSON returning a string. We can use the REST JSON unit, which has a tJSON class, and a tJSON class that has a function object to JSON string that can turn any class into a JSON string, and that will respect the tDateTime fields and will actually return it to a dateTime string instead of the floating point value. So this is a bit more useful. So let's call the embedded marshalling function from objects to JSON and from a JSON string back to an object. So if we get a JSON string, we can turn it to Delphi class. Go to the web module unit, and instead of tEmployees, let's return a string. So let's now do the entire string conversion ourselves. So instead of creating the employees, after we execute the function, we need the emps of type tEmployees. We need to create the output, so emps is employees.create. Then we need to try finally. Now we need to free emps. Note that previously we didn't need to free the result, because result was the result of the function, and then Datasnapper is responsible for freeing the result of the function after we've marshaled and exported the output of the function. In this case, it's emsEmployee.create. Now we need to read the data from the FD query 1, and finally result as a string is just amps.toJSON. So that's the additional function that I created to convert my my object to a JSON string. So no more structures. This time we just export an entire string. So let's open the browser. And this was the previous example with the higher date as floating point. Let's see what happens if we do the conversion ourselves. Oops, this is slightly worse. We get the results and now employees, and there's 7700 lines more. Everything is converted to JSON, and if you look at the higher date, it is a datetime, a correct datetime that we want. However, the JSON string itself is now escaped, because instead of actual interpretable JSON, I return the JSON string here as my output, and apparently Delphi thinks, oh, that's a string with double quotes and characters, so we must escape it, because otherwise it might be interpretable as JSON. Well, I want it to be interpretable as JSON, but unfortunately it's unuseful in this way. We now have to get some extra tricks and get our hands on the actual output and be able to manipulate the output. And that's where we need a special invocation metadata class for. Now we're finally at the topic of this session, the TDS invocation metadata class. This is a really powerful class that we can use to manipulate the response that's being sent for my dataset server method. We can actually assign the response code, like 200, and the response message, like the string OK. So if a function executes correctly, you can return 200 OK. If there's an error, an exception, we can return 500 for an internal server error. And then as a response message, we return the actual exception text, so we know that something bad happened instead of something explicitly bad happened, like a query with an error or out of memory error or other exception, instead of just the internal server error. Most powerful, we can assign the response content. This is a string that we can really truly manipulate. So instead of the escaped JSON string, I can now truly return that JSON string that we need. And of course, with any content that we return, we should also assign the response content type, which by default is text slash HTML, but in our case it could be application slash JSON, or slightly later application slash XML if we want to export XML. The final property of the TDS invocation metadata is the query params, and that can be used to get your hands on the input parameters being passed on the URL. So something like a question mark field equals value. And that can be really useful if you want to have the export function, for example, and to output in a specific format, and have the format value itself being passed as a query parameter. And that's actually the last example that I will show in the session. But first, I'm going to show you the example where you can export truly useful and consumable JSON. So, time to get to the metadata. We need to add the DBX platform unit to the users clause to get our hands on the metadata. So metadata of type TDS invocation metadata. And with metadata, if we assign something to the response content, we can ignore the result of this function. So this result amps.toJSON can be ignored, because anything that we now use assign to the metadata will be the output of our function. So metadata colon equals get invocation metadata with the default parameter to create it if it's not already created. And now inside metadata we can return, for example, the response code and say 200 OK if nothing bad happens. We can set the response message to OK if you want to, but most importantly we can set the actual response content to my emps.toJSON. And this will have the actual convertible JSON and consumable JSON assigned to my response content without any prefix, headers, or any other encoding or escaping. Now, finally, it may be useful to have the response content type set to application/JSON so we can tell the receiving end that the text that we are sending is actually JSON. Okay, so let's see how this looks like. Start, open the browser, and close this one. So this was the JSON, the previous attempt, which was escaped. And now if we refresh it, now we get pure nice JSON. I know that I've got a JSON beautifier inside Firefox. But this really looks like an array of employees, array with items. Also note the field, the date, which is really a daytime. Camel case without the F and starting with a lowercase. We can also check the raw data. This is the raw data, which can be pretty printed into showing that this is really the JSON that I want to export. And with the function marshal an object to a JSON string, that function can also be reversed. We can also marshal back a JSON string to an object, which is really useful. And this is JSON that Delphi can understand by marshaling back to an object, but also JSON that a PHP or a JavaScript developer really will appreciate and understand and can use to build their web front ends or mobile front ends or any other tools that they want to use that use JSON. So what if we need another format instead of JSON? What if some party requires us to export XML instead? Well, for that purpose, I've extended the TEmployee class with a function toXML and the TEmployees class also with a function toXML. So apart from exporting it to JSON and marshaling it to JSON, we can also turn it to XML. Now, this is a little hard-coded TEmployee toXML. I have hard-coded the field names. We can use RTTI to make this a little bit more flexible. But for now, for this demo, I can return all the fields, have to escape the text fields to make sure there are no special characters that can interfere with the XML. So I have to HTML escape the values, put them into XML tags to make sure that this is a valid XML. And define the employees to XML, start with the employees tag, end tag, and then for all employees, embed the XML for that individual employee. Going back to the server method unit, so if we want to export this as XML instead of calling to JSON, we can call to XML. And then, of course, the content type should not be application/JSON, but it should be application/XML. With these two little changes, I can now run the application. And instead of outputting JSON that Delphi can understand and other developers can understand, I can also output XML. So this is my JSON output. If I refresh this, we get the XML output. It's the same values, the same hire dates, the same employees. It's just a different format. It's the XML output. Now, sometimes with a server method class, we want to be able to export both JSON and XML in the same function. So one end user, one development environment may want to have the result of the query in JSON format, but another client may want to have it in XML format because they can process XML in an easier way. That's actually possible by using the last feature of the metadata provider that we haven't done yet. So if we close this one and close the client, in my DS invocation metadata, there's a last property that I haven't used, and that's the query parameters. So I can check if metadata dot query parameters and it has values. So if the values of, let's say that we have a format query string that we want to pass on the URL, and let's assume that if format is assigned to the string XML, then I want the output to be XML. But otherwise, if it's not assigned to XML, we can just return the good old JSON, which most people would like to use. So let's say JSON application slash JSON. So now I'm using the query parameters to determine if the URL contains a format equals XML. So that's the URL for my server method, including the function name and parameters, then question mark, and then format equals XML. If that's the case, then I want to return the XML output. Otherwise, if it's not assigned to XML or if there's no format, I just return the JSON format. So let's compile and run this final example. So start and go to the browser. So this is the URL without format specifiers. So if I refresh the URL, we get the JSON. However, if I add the question mark format equals XML to the URL, we now get the XML format. If I change format XML to format XML or format whatever, we get the JSON output. So this is one server method class that can export both consumable JSON or consumable XML with just specifying the format specifier. With this code, I'm really flexible. I can use the TS invocation metadata to get my hands on the query parameters that are being parsed to determine whether I have to return XML or JSON or any other format that you want. And I can truly manipulate the output. I can truly send only the XML, only the JSON. No other JSON or function result strings have been added to the output. This is the pure JSON or pure XML that also Delphi clients can interpret and work with, but especially those other poor development environments that have no idea what a Delphi T dataset looks like. So this really adds power and openness to my DataSnap REST service. This is the end of my session. I hope you enjoyed it and found it very worthwhile. To contact me if you got any questions or comments, you can email me at bob@ebob42.com. You can find these slides as well as the source code for the examples that I've used in the session at my website www.drbob42.com/coderage12. During Coderage, my ISP is doing maintenance on my fixed IP address. So I apologize if my website is offline while you're trying to download my code, but please come back in a few days and try to download it later. Thank you. Apologies for the inconvenience. You can always also contact me by Skype using the ebob42 or drbob42 handles. I've got a page on Facebook, facebook.com/drbob42. You can follow me on Twitter with the ebob42 handle, or you can connect to me on LinkedIn to connecting to drbob42. But the best way to reach me is by email to bob@ebob42.com. Thank you again for your attention. I hope you found this worthwhile. If you got any questions or comments on DataSnap or any other Delphi related topics, you now know where to find me and where to reach me. Thank you, and looking forward to seeing you again.